What is going on, everyone? We are back again for a brand new video. Today is something special. You can see by the title, we got a big announcement. I'm gonna tease y'all, I ain't gonna draw it out. I'm gonna tell you straight up that I have decided I'm going, I plan to be competing in Summer Shredding 2019, the physique show, the bodybuilding show, out in Texas this summer. So this is the brand new series that you've all been waiting for, my whole prep, my whole build up, my whole just everything, bringing you along with me, and how I'm gonna be managing to get in the best shape that I've ever been in my life while working full time, while getting YouTube going. We are gonna get it done. Super, super excited to have something to really revitalize the channel, because I haven't had something that I can kind of stick on that I can consistently film for a while. But that being said, it seems, unfortunately for any of you powerlifting dons that follow me, I am going to be leaving the powerlifting goal behind for this year. I will talk a little bit more about why, but right now it is like 8:30 in the morning. We've got to get some food, go to the gym before work. So first things first, diet wise, what the hell are we doing diet wise to get shredded? So the years past, I've started at 3,000 calories when I'm starting my cut. The year previous, just the last year gone, the last summer, I started at like 2,700 calories to get the, just to get the ball rolling. But this year, right now, we got about 11, 12 weeks or something like that. We are going to, 12 weeks exactly, I think, and we're gonna be starting at 2,500 calories. So I have everything on my fitness pal. I'm just gonna pop that on the screen. So you're gonna be able to see that 50% is still coming from carbs. Protein is going to be still very, very high. I'm weighed in this morning, 173 point whatever kg. So which means 1 gram per pound of body weight is only 170-ish grams of protein. I'm going to be eating more than that, 180. So literally 1.1 to 1.3 is what I'm aiming per pound of body weight. That's kind of what I'm aiming for. So I'm always going to be above that mark. As the cut goes on, the protein is gonna stay very, very high and the rest are gonna start to drop. So that protein is just gonna be high all the way through. I'm gonna be keeping my fats very, very low. I like to cut high carb, and I think it's the best way for everyone. You're gonna feel better, your training is gonna be better, you're just gonna look better, your mood's gonna be better. Mentally, it's gonna help you in the gym because you're gonna still feel strong and capable, and that's what's gonna be keeping on your muscle. You're not gonna be losing your strength. Then we get over to the meal strategy. What type of way am I gonna be making my meals throughout the day? So, as you guys know, I work full time, so I get an hour lunch break, so there's always gonna be a meal that I'm gonna be eating when I'm in work. I'm gonna be having a small, high protein meal in the morning, and then hopefully, depending on, again, the day, because my work days, the time that I work each day in work is different. It's not a set 9 to 5. Sometimes I'm in 8 till 4:30. Sometimes I'm not in till 1:30 and I finish at 10. So it can just be a little bit tricky that way, but I'm gonna manage it as best I can. But mainly there's going to be that high protein meal in the morning. If I can go gym in the morning, that's when I'll then go to the gym. After the gym, I'll have a small little snack, eat something at work, and then eat something when I come home. So it's gonna be roughly between 3 to 4 meals a day. The last meal when I'm home is going to be the biggest one. All the other ones throughout the day are going to be quite small, very high in protein to be around my training. We're going to be having some turkey bacon, staple for my cut. And then we're going to have some egg whites as well. So I'm going to measure out how many grams of egg whites I have. I'm going to have to take out the yolks from these eggs, unfortunately, until I just get like egg whites by itself. And that's gonna be meal one. I'll show you what it is. Also plan to actually be taking this every single morning. Creatine, I'm just gonna have a scoop of this every single morning when I wake up. It doesn't matter what time of day you take it. It doesn't matter if you take it before training, after training, morning, evening, as long as you're just taking it consistently, because the creatine that you take today isn't gonna be really helping you for another couple of weeks down the road. You gotta build it up. So hopefully I can start taking this shit consistently. So I'm just gonna have scuba this, 5 grams, every morning, every day. and see if it makes a difference. Alright, so we're here, Circle K, the petrol station, the dreams, and apparently we do have blue monsters here. So hopefully I can cut myself a blue monster for the gym. And that is going to be my pre-workout because I don't really like taking pre-workout early in the morning. Oh my god, we don't have any. I guess I'll take a red. As you can see, we do have them sometimes. Okay, well, that was kind of embarrassing. Let's re-up that clip. What's going on, guys? So we just got ourselves a red monster that we fully intended just to get because I didn't want a fucking blue monster anyway, bitch. I feel like I'm losing you in absolute, my friend. So we are at the gym. Today we are going to be training some shoulders and arms. And day one, just something that's going to be fun, that's going to be quick, that I'm going to be able to just enjoy as my first training session back. I didn't want to come back and start with legs, just something that I can enjoy myself. And training wise, I'm going to be doing a new split. It's going to be legs, chest and back, shoulders and arms. The reason why I'm doing this, the main reason, is because my shoulders and my arms are my biggest lagging points in my physique, other than legs. All right, relax, okay? I know my legs are trash. I got chicken legs. Let's put that aside for a moment and let's be adults about this. When we're talking about the upper body, I feel personally that my shoulders and my arms lag quite a bit. Basically, being a natural, that's just like a normal thing that those two things lag. But I do also put little effort into them. I really don't put any effort. I hate training shoulders and I hate training arms. So if I just put them and force them to be together on a day when I'm fully fresh, no excuse, from the offset, exercise one, going hard at them, and I think hopefully I can make some progress. I do want to grow a little bit leading up to this. You can absolutely grow in a deficit, especially early on. So if I can grow, build some muscle a little bit early on in this cut, then just maintain when I shred and lose all the fat on top of that, it's just hopefully I'll definitely be able to get my shoulders to just have that more of a popping look. That's the plan. May not work, but we're gonna try it. Cardio wise, we are gonna be doing 300 calories worth of cardio, LISS, low intensity, steady state. So I'm just gonna be walking, incline treadmill. So that'll take about half an hour at the end of my session. If you cannot walk at the same pace for a minimum of 30 minutes, then there's not low intensity. So that's kind of how you can kind of gauge from that. So it's like a fast incline walk, and that's what's gonna be burning my calories there. So yeah, let's go train. You. Okay, it's raining right now, but that is it. That is the first workout done and dusted for the start of summer shredding. Right now, I need to get changed, shower, get ready for work. I'm then going to buy my meals. I'm going to go into Marks and Spencer's and show you the meals. Oh, there's water on my screen. Show you the meals that I'm going to be getting and eating and work for the next few weeks. And yeah, I'll bring you along with that. So right now, I'm going to get ready for work.
Oh, why has it started raining? It is now miserable.
I don't want to go work. Dark is grey, the shade I'm in. 49 more if your babes want sin. I had me a famous thing. Goals and things, gains and things. My house party, a babe station. Girls want to chase, it's a status thing. Send me the location. I'll be right here. I'll come check you, my baby. No time, no. Hey, free this? Max daily rate now, €9. Can you see this? Only €9.
The little small things like that, that really make my day.
Oh, in case you didn't know, it used to be €18 to park in here for the day. Yeah, I get like my parking expense, but that's still €18 out of pocket if I wanted to park here until I get them expense like each paycheck. So for it to only be €9 now, pretty nice. Also, this driver assistance camera thingy, I don't use it. I'm so used to be driving a shit bucket that I've just got to do it the old school way, you feel me? Mirrors, turn over your shoulder like this, turn over your shoulder like that. It's just what I'm used to. I'm only noticing this now. I don't know when, I don't know how, but I got a fucking hole in my Vapor Maxes. Just when I thought today was a good day. So here, Marks and Spencer's. These meals right here, 3 for €10. Get 6 of these, €20. That's my 6 meals for the week. Seems. And it's some good shit, like proper chicken tagliatelle. What else we got here? Some bacon parmesan. What else we got here? Tuscan sausage panini, like there's some good shit. If you're into this sort of shit, I don't like mushroom, but if you're into it, king prawn shit, like it's really good. There doesn't seem to be any preservatives. I was looking in the ingredients already. There might be way more fat. Where's the fat? Yeah, so there's probably a bit more fat in these than I'd like, but it's better than getting McDonald's and KFC every single fucking day. While I'm here in work in Dundrum, like it's the worst. It's the worst. You spend so much money, easily €10 to €15 per day. So this is like, I'm saving so much money, and these are a lot, like a healthier, not healthiest, healthier option for work. So this is what I'm gonna be getting. Tell them the story about the Pepsi. So I asked, you go, I go,
listen.
You're going to KFC, I ask you to get me a large Pepsi Max, right? He buys me two liter bottles in Tesco. Bitch,
listen to
that's
me.
Not what I wanted.
He asked Tam, listen to this, he asked Tam to go get him Pepsi. Tam was going Tesco, bear that in mind. He asked Tam, can you get me a drink?
I wanted a
he
large Pepsi.
I got you 3 large Crazy.
So work done. Gotta get the final meal in at home. I really appreciate you walking me to my car. So how
yo, what are all you niggas saying? What's out here? I'm just talk to you niggas in a minute. We telling
so yeah, I'll see you later. It was good to cheers for walking me to my car.
Shut the fuck up.
So we have made it home. It is like 35 minutes past 10, 25 to 11 ish. I'm gonna be having my last meal now. It's gonna be some rice. It's gonna be some beef. I'm gonna show you what it is, the calories on the screen and everything like that. And that is going to be today. So that is literally what a day in the life was like for me when cutting, while working full time, as you can see. So I was in workout, whatever, half one till 10. Tomorrow I'm in 10 till 6:30, so I'm gonna go to the gym after the work, which you're gonna see in the next vlog. So yeah, I'm gonna go make the food because I need to eat. I think about you all the time. Everybody. So hopefully you guys did enjoy. Leave a like rating if you are happy that we are getting involved in some summer shredding, and because I certainly am, and I think I'm gonna be bringing my best ever. Hopefully that is the plan. So like I said, leave a like if you're new here, subscribe, more videos coming very very soon, and hopefully I can bring you along on this full journey with me because it's very exciting. But apart from that, mukbang, stay saucy.